So maybe we can continue in 15 minutes with the clinical cases and the discussion and question. Of course, if you have the question, the webinar is also to share the knowledge. I know that you have lots of patients COVID-19 in Iran also. So I'm really interested in sharing with you your knowledge. So I just show you clinical evaluation. It's a patient who was 52 years old. Was a man. He had all the signs we know: the fever, the cause, the asthenia, the headaches, the myalgia. And he was not on China, but he has lots of contact with Chinese people and Italian who had the contact with the COVID-19. And he arrives in the emergency room with a saturation with 80%, and he was dyspneic, and he had bilateral crackles on the auscultation. He has a chest X-ray. It was in Italy, perihilar lesion, and with the lung ultrasound, we can see the B lines, and we can see also the irregularity of the proval line, and so. We were really it's really a patient who has the sign of the COVID-19. You can really see the B lines and the irregularity of the proval line. On the other side, it was a woman. She had 38 years old. She had a very high grade fever. She also arrived in the emergency room, and she has a diffuse muscle and joint pain. She had coughs, and she said that she was coming from an area in Italy where there is lots of COVID, and she had this kind of ultrasound image with only one B line on the C photo, and on the A and B she had a normal lung with the A lines, and finally she had a PCR test which was negative. I would like to share with you the cases of patients who were in the ICU in Bordeaux. Friends gave me these images, and we talk about during the video conference we did to explain you the really importance of the prone position in the patient who has the condensation. Sorry. So it was a man. He had 59 years old. He had high blood pressure, diabetes, coronaropathy. He has an obesity, and he was on the day 10 of intubation. He has no response to prone position. Whatever the position, there was no reanimation and no always the condensation. So you have done the CT scan, the whole full scanner with the lots and lots of lesions with the condensation. In the ultrasound, you can see that there is a, like Gervais said, an hepatization. You have the transformation of the lung, which is like tissue-like, with the white things. Could be hair bronchograms. That's lots of small parts of air who goes inside, but most of the lung is like a tissue is wet. On the left posterior apical, it's the same. You can see that there is nothing, no more aeration. Anterobasal, you have here you have the lung who is moving in the pleural effusion, because the patient is more than 10 days. Maybe he has also a pulmonary lesion from the ventilation or bacterial lesion. Here you have also the hepatization. There is nothing moving inside. Again here you can see there is nothing who's moving. And Here also, it's an oblique images, and you have the plural line. You have no plural line. You cannot see it, and you can see all the condensation. Another people, no, he smoke. He's also he has an obesity. He's also at the 10 days of intubation. But we can see the scanner, which is awful also. And on the posterior basal area, we have also the condensation. And on the other side, you can see also the condensation. But here, you can see that just after the patient was on the prone position, you can see the B lines, which is more than 50% of the screen, and but you can see there is a narrow variation because there is B lines and not no more consolidation. So that's a good image. We can know that on the posterior part of the body, the condensation is not here again. And you have the B-line again. On the other side, on the anterior part, because we are on the prone position, there is a consolidation. You can see that the lung is not moving, and there is an hepatization here. The last one is a patient 70 years old. Also, he has obesity, has a high blood pressure, and 21 days of intubation, and he has a recurrence of severe ARDS, but a good response to prone position. So you see the condensation. On the posterior part, you see there is a aeration, you know, also it's the probe is on the oblique position, so you can see the pleural line. You can see the irregularity here of the pleural line, but you can see the B lines, so there is no more condensation on the posterior part. On the anterior part of the body, you can see that there is no more visibility of the pleural line, and you can see the condensation. The lung is very like a tissue, and there is no more aeration. On the other side, on the posterior part, you can see the pleural line with the irregularity, but you can see the B lines, and there is no more condensation. So it's the kind of patient who is really a good responder to the prone position, which is really important for us to know that all the work we ask for the team is important and it's good for the patient.